Hello friends, in this video we are going to discuss about partition walls, their advantages, their different types and how they differ from load bearing walls. Partition walls, also known as stud walls. Normally, homes have two different types of walls. One, those support weight from above, and second ones are those that do not support any weight. Most of the exterior and few interior walls are load bearing, but the others serve just no purpose apart from dividing the interior living space into different sections. Such walls are known as partition walls. There are different types of partition walls, which vary in strength, durability, and appearance. In general, all the interior partitions are divided into two groups, assembled and frame-based. The first group includes partitions that are made of building materials like bricks, blocks, etc. And in the second group, we refer partitions constructed on a frame base to which the selected material like plywood, drywall, etc. is attached. Partition walls are designed as non-load-bearing walls. It may be of folding, collapsible or fixed type. So what is partition wall? A partition wall is a usually thin wall that is used to separate or divide a room. Partition walls in most cases are non-load-bearing walls, which means these walls only need to support itself and doesn't need too much strength. Difference between partition walls and load-bearing walls. Partition walls do not support any weight. They simply divide the interior space into rooms. Whereas, load-bearing walls serve as an important structural material as they transfer the weight of roof and upper floors to the foundation. Advantages of partition walls. Privacy. They provide privacy to the residents from sight and sound. Divide space. They can divide a huge space into a number of rooms. Occupy lesser space. They can be constructed as slim and sleek as possible. Lightweight and cheap. Partition walls are cheaper to construct as compared to bearing walls. They are lightweight and easy to construct, hence play a huge role in economical aspect of the building construction. Easily constructed in any position. Partition walls can be easily constructed at any desirable position. Different types of partition walls. Depending upon the material used, partition walls can be divided into following different types. Brick partitions. Brick partitions are one of the most common and budget-friendly types of partition walls. There are three types of brick partitions available. First is plain brick partition. Second is brick nogging partition. And third is reinforced brick partition. Plain brick partition walls are built using bricks that are laid in cement mortar and plastered on both sides. They are extremely strong, soundproof, and resistant to fire. A brick nogging partition consists of brickwork built up within a wooden frame and plastered on both sides. In reinforced brick partition, a reinforcement in the form of steel wire mesh or steel bars is provided for additional strength. Brick wall is known for its strength and can hold lots of shelves, wall cabinets, and paintings. Clay block partition. Hollow blocks made up of clay, terracotta, or concrete are generally used for the construction of partition walls. They can be either solid or hollow. The advantages of clay block partitions are they are lightweight, rigid, economical, powerful, and fire resistant. They are 100% natural green products. These homes stay cooler in summer and warmer in winter. They are good insulators for heat and sound. The thickness of this sort of partition wall varies between 6 cm to 15 cm. These walls are built in a similar fashion as brick walls. The blocks are provided with grooves on top, bottom, and sides. Grooves provide rigid joints and serves as key to plaster. The blocks are laid in cement mortar. Concrete partitions. Concrete partition walls are made up of plain concrete or reinforced concrete. Concrete partitions can be solid or hollow. And these slabs are either precast or cast in situ. Solid precast walls are made using precast posts that hold the slab in place. The joints are secured with cement mortar. There are many advantages of precast concrete panels over cast in situ method. They are strong, durable, easy to handle and install, faster construction, economical, fireproof, damp-proof, and environment friendly. Glass partitions. A glass partition wall may be made with either hollow glass blocks or glass sheets. The blocks are made of translucent glass and come in variety of sizes and shapes. However, square blocks are the most commonly used. The blocks are set in a bed of cement-lime mortar and may be reinforced with metal if the wall is particularly tall. Glass sheet partition walls utilize wooden frame or metal frame to hold the sheets in place all around the glass, which in turn is fixed to the walls and the floor. They are extremely effective in keeping out pests, noise, and are resistant to moisture. Glass partitions are inexpensive, lightweight, and simple in construction and provide reasonable privacy and noise insulation. The expense of maintenance of these partitions is far more, as the glass is liable to break when struck hard by anything. With the introduction of reinforced glass sheets, this threat is significantly minimized. The advantages of glass partitions are: glass partitions provide good aesthetics and allow light. They are damp-proof, soundproof, and heat-proof. They are easy to clean and maintain. They are cheap, lightweight, and easy to install. Wooden partitions, also known as timber partitions, block board, or plywood partitions. These type of partition walls consists of a wooden framework supported on the floor or walls. The plywood or block board shall be installed on the frame with the help of screws from both sides. The advantages of wooden partitions are: they are lighter in weight, cheap, strong, easy to construct, and environment friendly. But they have disadvantages as well, like they are neither soundproof nor fireproof. They are not suitable for damp locations. Such partitions are likely to decay or be eaten away by white ants. This type of partition is not permanent in nature and need to be replaced at time intervals. Nowadays, the use of timber partition walls is decreasing. Straw board partitions. A straw board panel is made up of solid core of compressed wheat or rice straw covered with recycled paper liners, which are stuck to both sides with non-toxic water-based glue. Straw board is an economical and recyclable source. The straw that is left over as a byproduct of harvesting wheat grain. In United States alone, 60 million acres of wheat are grown each year, resulting in 140 million tons of straw that is mostly disposed of by open air burning. This not only adds to global warming, but can also create severe seasonal air quality problems across the country. According to one estimate, it takes about 18 acres of wheat straw to build a 1,760 square feet house. And it takes the equivalent of 1 acre of clear-cut forest to build the same house. In the manufacturing process, high pressure and temperatures up to 240 degrees Celsius forces the straw to release a natural resin, which binds the fibers together. The high density and low oxygen content of the resulting panels makes them resistant to combustion, and since they contain no added resins, alcohol, or other chemicals, they don't release flammable vapors. A standard straw board panel has a 1-hour fire rating and noise level reductions from one side to the other side of 32 decibels. The product's workability is similar to wood, as it can be sawn, drilled, rooted, nailed, screwed, and glued. Lightweight wall attachments such as shelf brackets, picture frames, mirrors, and towel bars can be attached directly to the panel. Drywall partitions, also known as plaster board, plaster slab, wall board, sheetrock, or gypsum board partitions. The framework can be aluminium or GI, and it shall be fixed to false ceiling and false floor with anchor fastener. The joints are then taped and finished with gypsum jointing compounds. The gap between plaster boards is packed with one layer thermally bonded polyester slab. The gypsum board shall be screwed on frame and can be painted for final finish. Drywall partitions are the preferred choice of construction for a range of applications in homes, hotels, hospitals, schools, theaters, and industry. They can typically last for lifetime of a building unless they are subjected to abuse or alteration. The advantages of drywall partitions are: they are lightweight, fireproof, soundproof, faster installation, and environment friendly. Yet there are some disadvantages of this material, such as poor moisture resistance, fragility, inability to hold heavy objects. Metal lath partition wall. Where space is a constraint, this type of partitions can be used. A metal wire mesh and steel bars or channels are used in this partition. Hence, it is called as metal lath partition wall. In this type of partitions, steel bars or channels are placed vertically and horizontally for studding, and a metal wire mesh is jointed on steel bars or channels. And then this wire mesh is plastered with a very heavy coat of hard plaster. Here it is necessary to use a very hard setting plaster. The advantages of metal lath partition walls are, they are thin, strong, durable and considerably fire resistant. AC sheet or GI sheet partition wall. Asbestos is a silicate mineral excavated from asbestos mines and consists of long, thin fibers that are composed of microscopic fibrils. When bound with cement, it becomes versatile, strong, durable, non-combustible, rot-resistant, and waterproof building material. The asbestos fibers act as a reinforcement for the cement and increase its tensile strength. Asbestos cement sheet consists of 85 to 90% cement and 10 to 15% asbestos fibers. This type of partition walls consists of corrugated asbestos cement sheet placed in between plain AC sheets with cement mortar as infill material. AC sheet or GI sheets can also be fixed to a wooden or steel frame to form a partition wall. It is mostly adopted in works of temporary character. These type of walls are economical, lightweight, fire resistant, soundproof and fairly rigid if constructed properly. Wood wool partition wall. It is made up of shredded wood bonded with ordinary Portland cement, water and suitable cement setting accelerator. It is pressed under low pressure and ambient temperature. The composition and performance of the boards make them ideal for many different applications in building constructions. Wood wool boards can be directly fixed on wall with the help of anchor fixings or stainless steel nails. In some of the cases, the wood wool board can be directly pasted on a wall with the help of glass glue or compatible plaster material. The advantages of wood wool partitions are, they are thermally insulating, durable, non-flammable and self-extinguishing, compatible with all normal construction materials, high compression resistance and flexural strength, stable, sound absorbing and noise insulating. Surface offers good mechanical base for renders and plasters, easy and safe to handle, cut and work, and also they are eco-friendly. So friends, I have tried to cover all the information about partition walls in this video. If you found this video informative, don't forget to give it a like and share it with everyone you know. If I have missed any information or you have any doubts related to this topic, then you can mention it in the comment section. And for more such videos, just click subscribe to Engineering Motive and turn on the notification bell so that you won't miss a new video. Finally, thanks for watching.